We will be going back to our data types examples so as to understand the type conversion and type coercion. Because this is something we use most of the time while we are coding. Okay? So let's see what is type coercion and type coercion in action. So basically, type conversion is something when we are trying to change type of one value to another manually. Okay, that thing is called type conversion, because here we are changing the type manually of one value to another. And type coercion is something when JavaScript changes the type of one value to another under the hood. We don't have to worry about how it is changing, because it happens internally in JavaScript. Okay. So we will be seeing the examples of type conversion first. Okay, so let's take a variable. So here I have taken number inside of the string. Okay, so if we console log it, so what you think will happen? It will just console log the value. Okay, but if you notice here, it is in white color. That means this is not a number at all. This is of type string. If we check the data type of it using this type of, then we will get to know it is a string. Okay, and why I'm telling you this? Because my next example is related to this one only. Okay, so now if we try to add some number to it, for example 3, let's say. So what do you think what should come? Like if we add 3 to 123, in simple maths it should be like 126, right? 126. So now let's log it and see what comes in. So here something different happened. It added that 3 at the last of this 123, and that happened because of this plus symbol and this string. Okay, so whenever JavaScript sees this plus symbol when we are trying to add something to a string, then JavaScript triggers type coercion. Okay, that is what we'll be seeing the next, but right now you just need to know, like if you try to add something to a string, then it will gets joined at the end or at the starting based on your addition. For example, if I try to add something here, 23 plus data, then if I console log it, then 23 will get added simply as a string ahead of this 123. Okay, so as you can see, it got concatenated here. Concatenation simply means it just joined this one with this one, like this. 23 plus 123. Okay, so it gave us 23123. All right, so in type coercion, as I mentioned, we have to change the type of one value to another manually. So here we will be changing it manually using this number function. So don't worry about this function and its syntax at all. Okay, we'll be studying about the functions and everything in our upcoming videos. So for now, just all you need to know is we use this number function to convert a string value to a number. Now let's see this in console log first. before storing it into the actual variable so as to get a clear idea what is happening. Okay. So now what I did, I have passed this data which stores this 123 in a string into a number. So now let's see what comes here. So we got 123 as a number because it is not in white color at all. To show you what is happening clearly, we are logging it aside this, so you can clearly see what is going on. Okay, so now here, as you can see, this variable is returning value which is of type string, but when I am passing it inside of this number function, it is returning it in number value. Okay, and one more thing, if you are passing it in any function, for example in this number function, then it doesn't mean it automatically stores the changed value inside of this variable. Okay, so it simply returns the transformed value which again you need to store in some variable like this. Let's make it let, because I'm going to change it here. Or let's take a new variable to reduce the confusion. Data num. Okay, so now if we console log it, then you will see the type of data num, and we will see the type of data. Okay, so here we got a number stored in this variable and we got a string stored in this data variable. Okay, and this is not the only way with which we change a string to a number. Here is one other way as well. All we need to do is we simply need to use a plus sign right above your variable or your value. Okay, so I have used this plus sign before this string of number. Okay, so let's see what returns. If I refresh it again, I got a number. Okay, and because I have stored it into data num, so it is giving me a number. If I remove this plus sign, then if I refresh, then again we got a string. Okay, so there is one way and this is another way. And one more thing I wanted to tell you guys, so if we pass, so in this example we have passed a string of number inside of this number function, so it was giving us a converted value. Okay, so now if I try to pass some character in it, for example A, B, C, and we try to convert it into a number, then let's see what happens. Okay, so here we got NaN, that means not a number. So it simply means not a valid number in JavaScript, but somehow it is a number, but that is invalid. So that also, let me show you. Let's see the type of data num now. If we check the type of data num, then it is going to return number because it is a number at the end. Okay, it is a number, but it is an invalid number. So NaN means not a valid number. but it is a number. Okay, so this is not just one thing. We can convert a number into string as well. So let's see an example of converting a number into string. Okay, so let's put it back to data. Or we can comment it out. All we need to know is this. Okay, so now here we are going to change the type of a number to a string. So all we need to do is we just need to write string and we need to pass the variable, or we can pass the values directly as well, and make sure you are using the first letter in uppercase whenever you are using these functions. Okay, otherwise it would not work if you use it like this. Okay, so now we are trying to change this number into a string. Let's see what happens. So now we got this 123 in white color, which is coming from line 209, okay, which is this line. And if we see the type of this example, then we will get to know it is a string now. Okay, because we have converted a number into string. So now these are a little bit about type conversion. Now let's see type coercion in action. Okay, so type conversion, you got to know we have to change the type of the value manually by using either these functions or by using this kind of shortcuts, like adding plus in case you are changing a string into number. Okay, so in type coercion, JavaScript automatically detects the type of one value and it changes to the another value. Okay, let's see. For example, I am adding 3 plus 3. Then what do you think is the expected output of this? Here we have a 3 which is wrapped with this string, and we have a 3 which is of type number. So let's see. Let's comment it out. Okay, to reduce the confusion. If I refresh it, then here you can see it is returning 33. Because, as I mentioned earlier, we have used plus symbol and there is one string. So JavaScript triggered the concatenation and it converted this value into a string. So now it is something like 3 plus 3. It converted this value into string and it joined the string. Okay, two pieces of string JavaScript joined. So we got 33 in white color. Now if we check the type of this 33, so we are using a parenthesis again. Okay, so to make sure this got triggered first and this operation got triggered after this one. Okay, so let's see. So now we got the type of this value, this operation, as string, because JavaScript did type coercion here. I hope you are clear, guys, now. So let's see some other examples. And it only happens when we are using the plus symbol. Okay, so if we use another arithmetic operation like minus, then it will work the other way around. Okay, so it will convert this string into number like this, and then it will do the actual operation and it will return us something like this. Okay, so let's see. If I refresh it, then we got a value which is calculated by this, and it is in purple color. That means it is of type number. We can also check this. Let's wrap it in parentheses to make sure it gets calculated first. Okay, so now if we check the type, we will get to know it's a number now. Okay, so we can use some other arithmetic operations like multiplication. If we use the multiplication, then also it will change this string to a number. Okay, so now we got 9, and in this case I also want to mention that it should not be every time you need to use a number to change the string to a number. You can use both the values as string, and if there is an arithmetic operation apart from plus symbol, then it will change the values into number first and then it will do the calculation. So now if we refresh it, then you will get to see 9 again, because JavaScript will convert this value into number and this value into number, and then it will do the operation of 3 into 3. Okay, so it will be something like 3 of number multiplied by 3 of number, and then it will give us 9. Alright, so again after refreshing we got 9, and if you see the type of this, let me wrap it around the parenthesis, and then if we check the type of, then you will get to see it is number now. Alright, so this way JavaScript does the type coercion. Okay, and many times people come up like this type coercion is a bad practice and it leads to so many bugs, but it only happens with those who don't have a deep understanding of type coercion and how it works. Because if you have a deep understanding of it, then you can already prevent yourself from creating so many bugs, because you know how it is working, right? Because in most of the languages we don't have type coercion. Let me show you an example. For example, let's say if JavaScript doesn't have the type coercion, then how we would write, we would use it. Let's see. Let's take an example of a string. I am a, and then let's use plus symbol and 23. Okay, so now in this string, in this example, we have a piece of string, we have a number, and then we have a piece of string. If JavaScript would not have this type coercion concept, then how we had to write this? We had to first convert this string into string like this, or we had to wrap it around any function. We have to pass it in some function like this. Okay, to convert this value in the string first, and then we join it like this. Okay, I am a 23 year old boy. Okay, so with the help of type coercion, we don't have to do all these things by ourselves. JavaScript takes care of converting a type from one value to another. Okay, so again if I refresh it, then I'm refreshing it again, then you can see this 23 got converted into string and it got joined with the rest of the pieces of a string, like with this one and this one. Okay, so JavaScript did its job, it does the type coercion. Okay, so let's see another example. Let's take a guess like what should happen in this. So here I'll be taking an example of string of 3, plus 6, okay, and then I'm going to manipulate it. Guess number plus equals to, we can use this or we can make it simple for now, like this, guess number into 2, okay, and then minus 2. So what do you think, if I console log it, what will come? So let's console log it, and you take your time, you try to identify how it is working and what should be the output of this whole thing, okay? What should be the final output of this? And once you are ready, just play the video and let's see the output. Okay, so we got 70. And how it works this way? Because we have used a string and a number with this plus symbol. So what JavaScript did, it added 3 with this 6. It did the type coercion and it concatenated the 6 with the piece of string, which is 3. So it got something like string of 3 plus string of 6. Okay. So now here we have string of 36 stored in this guess number. Okay. And again, we are doing a math operation here. So what will happen? This asterisk have a high priority over this one, as we have seen in our previous videos in the precedence table, if you remember. Then now what will happen? This 36 will get multiplied by 2, okay? So what will happen? It will convert the 36 into number and then it multiply it with the number 2. Here again, type coercion happened. It converted this value to a number and it multiplied it by this, and then again this operation will happen, okay? Minus 2. So let's see if I remove this for now. So let's see what happens. It's 72, as we have seen already. It converted 36 from string to number and it multiplied it with the number 2. So we got 72 here, and then it did the rest of the operation, which is subtracting of 2. Okay, so something like this, 72 minus 2. So now we got the final result as 72 here. Okay, so now I hope you got a clear picture how this type coercion works and how much important it is if you are coding. So with this, now you are ready to move into the next lecture. And this is it for this lecture. So see you guys there.